There's a man who decided to attack an 11-year-old black child. He receives, in my opinion, a light sentence. Put his picture up full mast. You're looking at Larry Wayne Baldner, 74 years of age, a North Dakota man, was sentenced to 2 years for physically attacking black children who were playing outside. Now, they were playing outside of his home, but that is not a criminal offense. I will explain why. Baldner started the confrontation after finding five children playing basketball in a driveway that he shared with neighbors at his duplex home on September 21st, 2021. And he told them to leave his property. Further background on the incident, an 11-year-old who lived next door, he knew her, lived next door, told police they were playing on her family's side of the sidewalk, according to a criminal complaint. But she said the man used a racial slur and slapped the 11-year-old child across the face. The girl and her sister confronted the racist, Mr. Baldner, who then grabbed the 11-year-old by the neck and hair, lifted her off the ground, and began choking her, according to the complaint. The sister struck Baldner in the face and helped her get away, but the child's hair extension was ripped from her head, and the older man then hit the sister in the face. These are small children. The defense attorneys requested the judge to sentence him to time served, which would amount to 3 days, and place him on 90 days of home incarceration. And they argued that the one child who had been present claimed the 11-year-old pushed Baldner, who denies using a racial slur. Prosecutors said Baldner was unrepentant and called the charges against him a crock, despite pleading guilty to aggravated assault, a Class C felony, the simple assault, a misdemeanor. Baldner repeatedly minimizes his own conduct and attempts to shift blame to the victims, according to the prosecutor. So here's the thing. Why did you let him plead? Why did you let him plead? Why give him a deal that is not required by the Constitution nor by law? You do not have to give anyone a plea deal. It is not a constitutional dynamic that's protected. You have the right to due process. You have the right to this trial. That's what you have the right to do. So don't wax poetic now about how the individual never took responsibility, but you decided to allow him to take a plea. You are now not taking responsibility, DA. You allowed the plea, knowing full well he had absolutely no remorse for what he had done, and still blamed the victims. He abused children. The man abused children. He gets 2 years. He is probably going to have much of that probated with something called good time after he serves a certain amount of time. If we continue to treat criminals who engage in child abuse, race-based child abuse, with kid gloves like this, what incentive do they have not to attack our children? So I don't buy it from the DA. This was a light sentence, especially given the attitude of this individual who decided to not take responsibility and throughout the entire ordeal blame children for his actions of criminality. Sharon, thoughts on this?
I think you're exactly right. He beat this child. Yeah. I heard everything you said, Doc. Choked, lifted off the ground, yeah. The hair, the whole thing. You assaulted a child, and you're allowed to just plead. Some people need to be made an example of. Mm-hmm. This is one. That's one of them.
That's right. And that's the kind of language relegated typically to gangsters, right? So there's a gangbanger somewhere. Oh, we're going to make an example out of this person, hold a press conference. They have all the law enforcement behind them. But why not for people like him who abuse children? All right, I'm waiting for a DA to say, I'm going to make an example out of a white supremacist.